Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this video we'll be doing this Photoshop Elements colored pencil sketch effect. We're doing it on this picture right there and giving it this effect as if it's been drawn with colored pencils. Check out my channel for more fun projects. I'm currently doing Photoshop projects on Thursdays. On Saturdays I'm doing either a Photoshop or a Photoshop Elements. On Monday I'm doing Photoshop Elements. And then just for fun, on Tuesdays, I'm doing some Minecraft stuff. Okay, let's get to it. Here's the original photograph for this project. We'll be working with just the face, so let's get that taken care of first. I'll go to the Zoom tool and then click on Fill Screen. That fills it left and right. So right about in here, and I want to have this crop to a 4x6 and a little bit smaller than this. This is a zoom at 121%, as you can see there. I'm going to back this out just a little ways. 94 looks pretty good, so a 94% zoom on that, and we'll reposition just a bit. So right about like that. So begin with fill screen, take it out to 94%, and then position it about like this. There's some space here above the head. Let's now crop in on this. We'll grab the crop tool right down there. And I have mine set for 4x6 ratio. And it gives you a little pre-built window like this. Just bring this in now so it kind of centered in here. Give yourself a little bit more space above the top of the head right there. So somewhere around here looks pretty good. And then click on the green check mark. That then crops us into that spot. We can then go back to the zoom tool and fit screen. And now we're all set to go with the rest of the project. Now we need to have her removed from her background. We'll be doing our own background on this. So we'll start by taking the lasso tool or polygonal lasso tool. Either one is fine. I'll use a regular lasso tool. And let's just do a nice little lasso right around the hair, just outside of the hair, just like this. Down to the bottom, just go clear across the bottom and then back again on the other side. There we go. And then we'll be using the Refine Edge tool on this to clean this hair up. Okay, this is one of those spots actually right now where if you're using Photoshop Elements, you can feel very happy about this. The Refine Edge tool in Photoshop Elements works a lot better than the new Select and Mask tool over in Photoshop CC, which really does a poor job nowadays. They've really managed to somehow ruin that tool. Not sure why, but it doesn't work very good any longer. Okay, edge detection. Check where it says smart radius. Your brush size is right down here, 35. And that's pretty good for this. And just come in here and just paint right along that edge. And then just work your way in. And go clear around the whole figure in little steps, just like that. Start out and then work in closer and closer. And we'll just go through and do the whole figure in here. Again, like I said, the tool that's now over in Photoshop is actually pretty bad. I don't know how they managed to mess that one up, but they did. And now this tool is better than the tool in Photoshop. Okay, let's work our way clear around this side. And once that's done, we'll be all set to begin putting in our filter effects on this. The whole thing is done very quickly and easily, actually, with just some real simple filter effects. This is the hardest part of the whole process, is getting this masking done. Now, if you notice, I'm using this with the red mask view. It's one that I like using the most. I just find it really easy to see in most instances. So that's done. Now come down here where it says Output 2 and change this to New Layer with Layer Mask, and choose OK, and there's our layer mask. Let's now make a copy of the background. Either drag it up to the New Layer button right here, or just right-click on the name and choose Duplicate Layer. There you go. Leave those both hidden. The reason we did this is because we're putting in a new background back here, and that's going to overwrite this background image right there. So that's our safety for our image. And let's now change this background. Come down here to graphics, and then I'll go clear to the top up here. There it is. We're in backgrounds by type, and then scroll all the way to the bottom. Just grab the scroll bar, pull the scroll bar all the way to the bottom. There we are, and right there is one called white and green. Just click on that. That brings in this kind of a nice, interesting background. Now it's too rough for our use, so we'll go back to layers. There's the background. Now make a copy of this layer. Duplicate layer. There we go. Hide the original. I'm doing that because we'll be changing this one. We're actually blurring this out just in case we get it wrong or you want to change it in the future. You can go back here to the original one. Okay. Now notice right down there, a little kind of icon bottom right-hand corner. That means that this is a smart layer, smart object. We don't want that. So right-click where it says background and choose simplify layer. Okay. Now we can blur this. Go up to filter, come down to blur, come down to the Gaussian blur right there. And I have mine set at 5 pixels. And choose okay. It just kind of softens it up, gives it kind of that studio background effect in there. But this has more stuff happening in here than the original white background. Before she had a white background and just some gray up there and that was it. This gives us a bit more texture, a bit more interesting. Okay, now let's get to work on the actual image. There's our base image. And I'm going to rename this. I'll just type over here and call this portrait. There it is. A little hard to see that, but I'll pull this side. If you go right against the edge here of the layers panel, should be able to get, there it is. You can catch the edge, actually pull that out a bit like this. You can actually adjust the width so you can read those names better. Okay, let's take the portrait layer, make a copy of this one, right click, duplicate layer, choose OK. There it is. This one is going to be our poster edges layer. And then go up here to filter, come down to filter gallery. And in the filter gallery, you want to be an artistic and poster edges right there. And the settings are 0 on edge thickness, 0 on edge intensity, and 1 for posterization. After you try this a couple of times, you can play around with these settings. You'll get a little different effect with these different things. You know, moved a little bit. It's up to you which way you like. This is a harder look by bringing up the edge intensity. You can see it in there. But I'll leave these both at 0 and then 1 for posterization. Choose OK. And that gives us our basic graphic effect onto the image. But we can improve this with some more layer work. Come back down to the portrait layer here. And then take this layer and duplicate this again. There we go. Pull this new layer to the very top. And let's rename this one. This is going to be glowing edges. There we are. Okay, back up to filter, come down to filter gallery. This time come down here to stylize. Let me close the artistic. There it is. Stylize glowing edges right there. Edge width at 2, edge brightness at 20, smoothness at 5. And it looks just like that. Choose OK. There it is. Pretty bizarre looking, I admit. It's also in a negative format, as you can see, so we need to fix that. Go up to filter again, come down to adjustments, and invert, and it goes back to a positive, but it's really pushing on the colors, you can see here. So we're now going to blend this into the layer underneath. Use our blend modes and come down to soft light, and that blends that in. What that layer does is it gives us the hard drawn edges in here. Let's now take the poster edges layer and blend this in with the original portrait to soften things up. Back up here to the blend mode, come down to screen, and that brings that layer down into that layer. And we're getting very close look now to our kind of a pencil drawn effect. But we don't have any real nice lines happening in here. We can fix that by going down to the portrait layer again, right click, and duplicate layer. Choose OK. It should be right above the portrait layer right there. It should say portrait copy. This one is going to be crosshatch. There it is. Okay, go up to filter, come down to filter gallery, not the top one, but the second one right there. And this time, go up to Brush Strokes and Cross Hatch. There it is. And the settings for this is 50 on stroke length, 18 on sharpness, and 2 on strength. It'll look kind of like that, kind of weird looking. Choose OK. There it is. We now need to blend this in to our portrait layer. So you're on the crosshatch layer, change this to soft light, and that blends that in. And we now have some little drawn lines in there on top of everything else. Last little bit, we've kind of lost detail over here on the right side of her face, left side of our screen. Lost that jawline in there, and it's kind of bad up here. We can fix that. If you go up here and you show and hide the poster edges layer, notice that's where that's going away. It's that one layer, the poster edges. With that on, you're losing that bit. We're getting a lot of our contrast in there, which I want, but we're losing that bit here. So we need to hide the poster edges. There it is. On just this part. We'll do that by going to the right-hand side here. Look for that light blue outline onto the layer mask. Grab the paintbrush. Make sure your foreground color is black. I have my brush set at 100 pixels and opacity at about halfway. 44% is fine. There's the brush. And then just brush right in along that jawline right there. Because it's down to 44% on the opacity, you can hit it a few times until you adjust the effect. A little bit right up in here and right down there around the jawline. Brings that jawline back in again. And there we go. There's our colored pencil drawn effect based on that photograph. Let's see how that looks. I'll go to the background copy down here. We can now take this and pull this clear to the top. There's the original, and there's our colored pencil sketch effect. Original, colored pencil sketch effect. As you can see, it's actually very easy to do. It doesn't really take any artistic ability in here to do this. It just takes knowing the right sequence of these different basic filter layers.